Hello viewers, reporting from newszimbabwe.com, I am Makana Kamasinyama. Civil society and church leaders have accused the ZANU-PF-led government of monopolizing state resources, using them to their own personal use while the masses continue to suffer. This they said on Monday at a Zimbabwe Indaba that was attended by hundreds of activists that have been at the cutting edge of Zimbabwe's drawn-out democratic struggle. Speaker after speaker told of how citizens continue to wallow in poverty when the country is endowed with vast mineral wealth such as diamond and gold, as well as timber and many other riches. Isao Ngube, a representative from Matabeleland North, fingered ZANU-PF for abusing the country's resources for its own good.
World-class quality timber is being harvested by ZANU-PF barons in Cholocho, Mkuza, Ukai, Lupane, and Wai. It has not translated into school furniture for our children. Primary school children still sit on chairs that they bring from home homes or Tongana. We want a political dispensation that will bring to closure the issues, the horror of Mukurawundi, and not push empty. Unity and institute national reconciliation. Those words are meaningless to us in these circumstances we are in. We want a Mukurawundi commission. The people want to know the truth about why Mukurawundi, why did the government deploy Mukurawundi, and who was part of it. And I must also ask them to say, gone are the days of demanding an apology for Mukurawundi. We don't want an apology for Mukurawundi. We want justice for Mukurawundi.
We have hungry families that are deprived completely of anything that they can have because the government believes that they have to take food and whatever above our heads so that we jump and just to their choice. We need independence, please. Can you give us a chance to be people of Matabeleland South and be the people of Matabeleland South? We do not want Matabeleland South to be Mashonaland West. We do not even want it to be Matabeleland North, in case I'm taken to be talking tribalism. We want to be Matabeleland South. Give us our riches and let us benefit from what we have.
Ankleston Sibanda, president of Civic Society and Joint Church Forum, also touched a storm when he tried to justify government's recent 2% levy imposed on electronic transfers. Delegates booed him until he had to water down his statement, saying the 2% levy will benefit Zimbabweans only when there are no corrupt elements in government. Other delegates from the diaspora praised Zimbabweans for their resilience in the wake of a crippling economy crisis that has gone on for almost 2 decades.
What we are so impressed about as the diaspora when we look to Zimbabwe is your resilience as a people. Because through it all, you still stand.
Themed Reclaiming the People's Struggle Beyond Political Curtains, the Harare Indaba was the first of its kind since July 30 elections, which restored ZANU-PF's two-thirds parliamentary majority and also allowed President Emmerson Mnangagwa to escape with a narrow victory. Top human rights activists, among them Justina Mukoko and politician come feminist Linda Masarira, also graced the occasion. Reporting for newszimbabwe.com, I am Makanaka Masenyama. For these and more stories, visit our website www.newszimbabwe.com.